Steel is the world's most popular metal, and rightly so. Not only is it incredibly versatile, with 1,001 different uses, it can also be incredibly green.
Because steel is one of the very few man-made materials that's 100% recyclable. And for this reason, steel scrap very rarely goes to waste.
And this is great news, because for every tonne of steel recycled, you save 1.5 tonnes of iron ore, 0.5 tonne of coal, 75% of the energy and 40% of the water that you need to make steel from scratch. Air pollution is also reduced by 86% and water pollution by 76%. Plus, you save yourself the job of getting rid of 1.25 tonnes of solid waste. In this case, recycling definitely makes sense.
This recycling and reuse of steel has been going on for generations. In fact, your knife and fork could have been made out of the remnants of a Victorian bridge, an old battleship, or even a sword wielded at the Battle of Waterloo. And the process goes on, even today.
Now, if I ask you to name a classic piece of 1950s American design, the steel shipping container probably isn't the first thing that springs to mind. But I'll tell you what, you can't argue with success.
Steel containers in one form or another have been around for most of the 20th century, but it was the Americans back in the 1950s who were the first to standardize the boxes. This led the way to a fully integrated road, rail and sea transport system. Today, 90% of the world's goods are transported in steel containers, and there are an estimated 200 million of them worldwide. And after 10 years or so of being loaded and unloaded and shipped around the globe, they tend to get fairly beaten up and are often retired, even though many of them are still structurally sound.
With millions of these old containers piling up around the world, there's growing interest in finding new uses for them. So how do you fancy living in a steel house?
And the reason why steel containers like these convert so easily into buildings is down to their inherent structural strength. Because of this, they require just a simple concrete base, and they can be piled up to 10 stories high. That's just what these people have done on this groundbreaking development in the heart of London's Docklands. Ian Feltham shows Jonny round.
Oh, come in.
Wow, this is amazing. I have to say, this is not what I was expecting at all. What's it like living in it?
It is just like living in a normal house. When you're actually in here and you're going about your everyday things, cooking and sitting down at dinner and stuff, it's just like a normal apartment somewhere.
And what about when there's heavy rain? Is it loud?
It's so well insulated. I mean, I think you probably get a little bit of pitter patter on the steelwork, but in a kind of nice way.
Yeah, it's quite a reassuring sound, isn't it? So this is quite a wide room. So it's obviously not a single container.
This is 2 40-foot containers. Basically cut down the middle and joined together. You can see the join runs right the way through. And then the two containers go back there, and I've got the bathroom and the bedroom the other side.
Yeah, it's a lot more spacious than I was expecting. It's really nice. Well, thanks very much for showing me around.
No, you're very welcome.
All the best.
Cheers.